Good morning, dear students. Welcome you all. Today we will start a new chapter of English grammar. The chapter name is adjectives. In this class we will discuss about kinds of adjectives, comparison of adjectives and the position of adjectives. So come on the chapter and try to know about the chapter in detail. Adjective. An adjective is a word used to add something to the meaning of a noun or pronoun. Add something to the meaning of a noun or pronoun. Understand? Enhance the meaning of noun or pronoun. So here, one example is given. Several questions. The word question is, the word questions is noun and several is here used as a adjective. As an adjective. Understand? Adjective of a number. Afterward, in this class, we will only discuss these kinds of adjectives. So, here, kinds of adjectives are descriptive adjectives, which we know adjectives of a quality. Second one is demonstrative adjectives. Third, possessive adjectives. Interrogative adjectives. And last one is adjectives of a quantity. Adjective of a quantity. So here we are going to discuss these. Understand? One by one. Dear students, whatever is written on the blackboard, you have to write in your grammar copy. Come on. Here. So first is we are going to discuss descriptive adjective, which we know adjectives of a quality. Adjectives of quality show the quality of a person or thing. So the quality of a person or thing. So here you are getting, she is a good girl. One thing you have to keep in your mind that adjectives always come, mostly adjectives come before, adjective comes before noun. So here you are getting the word girl is noun and good word is adjective of a quality. Understand? Adjective of quality show the quality of a person or a thing. It show the quality of the pronoun she. The second example, sorry, second definition, demonstrative adjectives. The adjective used to point out some person or thing is called demonstrative adjective. This, that, these, those and such are demonstrative adjectives. Understand? So I have also told you that after adjectives, nouns come in most cases. Understand? So here you are getting, this man will guide you. The word this is here demonstrative adjective. Man is noun. Here these, those. The plural of this is these and the plural of the word that is those. Understand? This and these are used for nearness and that and those are used for indicating distance. So these are those. You can use anyone. Pains are mine. Here this and in this sentence these and those are demonstrative adjective. Understand? Because you are getting noun after these words. Possessive adjectives. Possessive adjectives show possession or relation. So possession are a relation. My, our, your, his, her and their are possessive adjectives. That show possession or a relation. Come on the example. This is my, your, own, sorry, our, his, her, their. You can put any one of them. So this is my school. This is your school. This is our school. This is his school. This is her school. This is their school. Understand? And school is a noun. Understand? School is noun. And all these are what? Possessive adjectives that show position. Dear students, come on the 4 point interrogative adjectives. Interrogative adjectives. WH words are called interrogative adjectives when they are used with nouns to ask questions. When WH words will be used with nouns, it means that they will be known as interrogative adjectives. Come on the examples. Whose box is this? What question did he ask? You are getting the WH word here in both sentences, and afterward you are getting noun. So it means that these are known as interrogative adjectives. After interrogative adjectives means after WH word, noun must come. Understand? Nouns must come. Come on the next and the last. Adjectives of quantity. Adjectives of quantity show how much of a thing is meant. They include numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 7, 8, 9, etc. And words like all, both, much, many, enough, some, whole, any, etc. Understand? Come on the example. The whole money was distributed. He did not eat any rice. So here you are getting the word whole in this sentence, and here you are getting the word any. These words are telling about the quantity, money, which we don't count. So here it will tell about the quantity with whole money. Understand? So any rice we also use here the word any to tell about the quantity. Understand? Let's see position of adjectives. There are two main positions for adjectives. They come before a noun. Example, this is a useful book. Book is noun and useful is here an adjective. Or after a verb like be, become, feel, seem. Understand? So you have seen that the verb like be verb is am, are, was and were. Become, feel, seem. So understand? So here you are getting this book is useful. After is you are getting the word adjective useful here. Understand? A few adjectives are normally used only after a verb. They include some adjectives are here, they will be used after verb. These are afraid, alive, alone, asleep, glad, sorry, ill. Look at the examples. The girl is alone. Understand? The girl is alone. So, adjective is alone. He felt sorry for it. The word sorry is an adjective. And afterward, you are getting the word felt. After the word felt means feel, second form of the verb feel. You are getting the word sorry as an adjective in a sentence. Understand? According to the rule, they include afraid, alive, alone, asleep, glad, sorry, ill after these words. So after feel, the word is here what? The girl is alone in the example you are getting, and he felt sorry. After the verb you are getting feel. Suppose that according to example here you are getting that the verb is like be, become, feel, seem. After that we get what? Adjective. Understand? And after the word is, am, are, was and were, we are getting the adjectives. Understand? After verb. Come on the next. A few adjectives like eastern, western, northern, southern, indoor, outdoor, etc. are normally used only before a noun. These words will be used before nouns. Eastern, we are getting Eastern parts, western ghats. The word parts are noun here, ghats. The word both of the words parts is here noun and ghats is here noun. And western and eastern are adjectives. Understand? Come on, comparison of adjectives. We use as and as to show that two people or things are equal in some way. For example, Mary is as tall as Tom. In positive degree, we will use as and as adjective, sorry, as adjective and as. Understand? We will use as adjective as. For what purpose? To show that two people or things are equal in some way. Understand? When two things or people will be equal, and when we are going to compare, on that time we will use as and as in positive degree. Afterwards, second degree is comparative degree. We use comparatives to show that two people or things are different in some way. When we are going to compare two things or two person, understand? So on that time we will use comparative degree, and in comparative degree we are using than. Understand? And here you are getting er included. So Mumbai is larger than Mysore. In the example you are getting that Mumbai is larger. When we are going to compare two things, two person, comparison of two. Understand? So Mumbai is larger than Mysore. Mumbai is larger. We can express the above idea in another way. We can use not as, as instead of er than or more than. Instead of er than and are more than, we can use here not as, as to express the idea. Understand? Bereft of er than and bereft of more than. Look at the example. Mysore is not as large, largest adjective as Mumbai. So in this way, here we are getting Mysore is not as large as Mumbai. So Mumbai is also here larger than Mysore. By using not as and as, we are comparing here. Understand? We can compare by using not as and as also. Come on the next. We use superlatives to compare three or more people things. When we are going to compare three, more than three or three, we will use superlative degree. And in superlative degree, we use the before superlative degree. Keep in your mind, America is the richest. We are using the, and we are including ST, EST here. And here we are including in comparative degree, ER. Understand? This is the most difficult. We are also including the more word, more word we will also include in comparative, and here most. We will discuss about these further. This is the most difficult question in the paper. So here the adjective is the most difficult. Understand? When we are going to compare more than three, this is the most difficult question in the. Understand? Dear students, we use ER and EST for short words, one syllable adjectives. There are sometimes changes in spelling. Understand? With one syllable, we use what? ER and EST. So come on the small, smaller, smallest, young, younger, youngest, hot, hotter, hottest. these words, these adjectives are one syllable. So here you are getting in this adjective heart one vowel plus one consonant. The consonant will be double. So here you are getting one vowel and one consonant. Understand? So one vowel here you are getting and one consonant. So in comparative and superlative degree you are getting the consonant will be double. The consonant will be double. And afterward we will include ER and EST. Understand? The same will be followed here. Small, smaller, smallest. You are getting two. Already you are getting here two consonant. Only we are including ER and ST. Understand? Suppose that we are getting top or TOP. Top, topper, topest. Double P. Because before P, one vowel and P is consonant. Understand? Afterward we are getting wise, wiser, wisest. Words ending with E. Here you are getting the words ending with E. Then we will use E is dropped. Afterward what will happen? E will be dropped. And we will include ER and EST. In this example you are getting that the word E is not included. ER and EST. ER is used and EST is used. Understand? And E has been dropped. Otherwise you will get here double E. We also use ER and EST for two syllable adjectives that end in Y. That end in Y. The Y is changed to I. Before adding ER and EST. Before adding and ER and EST, we will drop Y and we will include I. Understand? We will include I and we will drop Y. Understand? ER and EST for two syllable. Two syllable means you are getting happy and afterward we are getting Y. Means that two syllable happy, happy. So we are dropping Y and including I and afterward ER, EST. Understand? We use more and most for words ending in FUL, full, less, ING, ED and many other two syllable adjectives. And many other two syllable adjectives. With these two syllable adjectives we use what? More and most. Look at the example. Careful, more careful, most careful. You are getting careful, two syllable. Fearless, two syllable. So in this way the words, the adjectives which will be more than two syllable, with them we will use more and most. Suppose that beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. So with beautiful we will use more and most. Come on, here adjectives of three or more syllables take more and most. Understand? More than three or more syllables. So you are getting here beautiful, beautiful, expensive, expensive. Three syllable. So with three syllables we will use more and most. More beautiful, most beautiful. More expensive, most expensive. The following take either ER, EST or more and most. We can use more or most, either ER, EST in comparative and superlative degree. In comparative and superlative degree, more able, most able. Understand? Abler, ablest. So common, commoner, commonest, more common, most common. We can use in these two ways: able, common, cruel, gentle, handsome, narrow, pleasant, simple, sincere, stupid. Understand? Some adjectives are, irregular, good, better, best. Understand? Many more, most, much more, most. So we have to learn these adjectives. So I hope that you have understood all these. Thanks for watching the video.